This video lecture talks to you about motility of bacteria by hanging drop method. Aim of this experiment is to prepare and observe hanging drop slides to demonstrate the motility of bacterial cells. Principle of this experiment. The simplest method for examining the living microorganisms is to suspend them in a fluid, which can be water, it can be saline, or it can be a broth. Prepare a hanging drop using a cover glass slip and a cavity slide. The slide is ground with a concave well in the center. The cover glass holds a drop of the suspension, and when the cover glass is inverted over the well of the slide in such a way that the drop hangs from the glass in a hollow concavity of the slide. This technique is especially used to determine the ability of the organism to move independently in liquid cultures. It is very essential to distinguish between true motility and the Brownian movement. Now, what is true motility? It is independent movement which is brought about by different mechanisms of self-propulsion, which can be with the help of even the flagella. Whereas when we talk about the Brownian, it is movement. Movement of the water molecules. So in the true motility, the organism changes its position in the field, whereas in the Brownian movement, which is a false movement, is due to the oscillatory movement of very small non-motile forms when they are suspended in the liquid. Now, what is the factor which is contributing for the motility of the bacteria? So that is with the help of this flagella. So motile bacteria move by the use of flagella that are thread-like locomotor appendages extending outward from the plasma membrane and cell wall. Bacterial flagella are slender, rigid structures which are about 20 nanometer across, and it can extend up to 20 micrometer in length or long. Bacterial species differ distinctively in their patterns of flagella distribution and are also used in identifying bacteria. For example, Monotrichus bacteria. The word trichus means it is hair-like. So in the case of Monotrichus bacteria, we can observe the position or the arrangement of only one single flagellum. And if this one single flagellum is located at one end of the bacteria, we call it as polar flagellum. So the best example for Monotrichus bacteria is Pseudomonas species. Amphitrichus bacteria, the word A-M-P-H-I, amphi means on both sides. So it is having a single flagellum at each pole. Lophotrichus bacteria, the word lopho, L-O-P-H-O, means it is tough. Of bacteria. So it means cluster of flagella at one or both the ends of the organism. So the example is spirella. Peritrichus bacteria, P-E-R-I, peri means around. So flagella are spread evenly over the whole surface of the bacteria. Example, Proteus vulgaris. There are four major methods of movement which have been observed in the bacteria. First one is called as the swim movement, which is conferred by the flagella. Corkscrew movement, which is observed in the case of spirochetes. Twitching motility as associated with type 4 pili, and the gliding motility. Now, what are the basic requirements for hanging drop method to determine the motility of the bacterial cells? We require 24 hours actively growing broth cultures, sterile nutrient broth, 2 cover slips, Vaseline grease or petroleum jelly, cavity slides, inoculating loops, and a toothpick. Now coming to the procedure of this experiment. First, prepare a suspension of overnight culture in the broth. Then we are going to incubate it for 2 to 3 hours to have actively growing cells. Next step, place a little amount of grease with the help of a toothpick to the four corners of the clean cover slip. Now place a drop of suspension, which is having the actively growing cells, onto the center of this cover slip. Then invert the cavity slide over the cover slip to adhere to the grease and turn it upside down quickly. Next, cover slip is up and the drop will be hanging in the cavity. Now make sure that do not let the drop fall or touch the bottom of the cavity. Examine the hanging drop under the microscope. First, locate the edge of the drop in the center of the microscope with a low power objective, and then reduce the light to create a dim background. Then look for the edge as bright wavy line against the background, and now turn the hyper objective and focus the edge of the drop with the fine adjustment. So this is a picture of on the first step, where you can find that this is the concavity slide or the cavity slide, or you can call it as a depression slide. So in the slide, in the center, you're able to see this one, which is the depression, what we can find in the case of this slide. Now this is the cover slip. This is a glass cover slip what we have taken. Keep it on a flat surface. Next, we are going to see that in the cover slip, four corners, if you are able to observe, there is small amount of grease which has been applied to the four corners of this cover slip. After that, take the slide, look where the depression is, and keep it inverted on top of the cover slip. Be made upside down so that the slide is down and the cover slip is on top of the cavity, in such a way that the sample what we have placed at the center of this cover slip will be hanging on the other side. So this same slide we have shown you on the other angle, where we can find that this is the slide and this is the depression in the center, and on top of it we have placed the cover slip. On the four corners you can visible the grease which we have applied. So the slide is there. On top of the slide we can see the cover slip, and if you keenly observe, in the center of this cover slip you can see the drop of the 24 hours actively dividing or actively growing cell suspension has been placed over here. Now, after this slide preparation, we are going to place the slide under the microscope and keep it at the low objective. So the moment you keep it under the low objective, now you have to focus it in such a way that first you are able to locate the edge of the drop. So in this picture, you are able to see that this is the edge of the drop which we have placed in the center of this cavity slide. So once we have got the focusing of this wavy line in the picture or under the low objective microscope, then we have to change it to high objective and then focus on to check out the motility of the culture what we have taken. So observation will be to observe for the motility of the bacteria and determine whether the given organism is motile or non-motile. And these are the reference books which we have referred in order to prepare the slides. Thank you, students. And after this lecture, we will be showing you the demo of this experiment, how we are supposed to perform the hanging drop method to determine the motility of the bacteria. Thank you. Have a good day.
Hello. Today we will be doing motility of bacteria by hanging drop method. So first thing is the requirements. So let me show you some of the requirements. So this is the slide. So in the video also I've shown you the slide, is it not? So this is the slide. In the center you can see that cavity. So that is depression is there. So that is this type of slide only you have to use for the hanging drop. So when I put my finger and see, there will be a gap here. So the depression will be observed. Okay. So take the cavity slide, the first thing which we require. Then we will be requiring the cover slip. So it's a glass cover slip which will be required. Then this is the sample, that is Pseudomonas culture we have taken, and some amount of the vacuum grease and toothpick for the experiment with the inoculating glue. So first what we will do is that we'll take some cotton and stir it, and we will first sterilize the area where we are going to take the suspension. So suspension what we are taking is going to be the 24 hour actively growing culture cells. So you have to take the sample and previous day itself you have to inoculate into the liquid broth, because motility can be observed only when you are putting the organism into an aqueous form, either water, saline or the broth. So after sterilizing the surface or the area where you are going to take the sample, the next thing is, this is the slide, so we will keep the slide aside. Then we are going to take the cover slip. So now the cover slip is a glass cover slip, so carefully you just take the one where all the four sides are going to be like this. So this is the cover slip, so you can observe the cover slip, it's a glass cover slip, square. So you can just take it, keep it first on the flat surface like this. Okay, then after that take a toothpick. And then we are going to take a grease. So this is the vacuum grease. So from the vacuum grease, we will take a little bit of it. So I just take a little bit of the vacuum grease and then put it on the corners, four corners of the cover slip. So I'm just applying the grease to the four corners here. So keep it on a flat surface and do it, because otherwise you won't be able to apply the grease properly to the four corners. So using a toothpick, just hold it and then add to the four corners. Okay. So after applying it, keep the toothpick just in its place. That's all. Don't do anything. Okay. Now what we will do is that we will take the suspension. So the suspension is here. So the cultures are here. Just you mix it together, it is Pseudomonas. So first you have to sterilize. So sterilize the loop. So once it becomes red hot, don't immerse it immediately into the suspension. Okay. So just we let it wait for a few seconds. Then we can take the sample. So after a few seconds, we'll just open the culture tube. Take near the flame, the mouth, go to the center and take a drop, and then see, you are supposed to place it in the center. The drop has to be placed, just one small drop of the sample. Then sterilize your loop and keep your suspension back in its place. Just sterilize the loop thoroughly. Now, this is the slide. Okay, so what we will do is that as I touch the slide, just we will clean it. Clean on both the sides so that there are no any sort of dust on the slide. Okay, now we are going to see where the depression is. The depression is this side. So you have to tilt it like this. Okay, after tilting it, depression is here. Observe the cavity, the depression is here, and come to your cover slip and place it in such a way that you are going to place the suspension in the center and just press it once and remove it and make it upside down.
So now you can see that you are having the cover slip and the drop will be hanging from the center of the cover slip. Okay, so that is how you will be able to prepare the slide now. So your sample is ready. You have taken the cover slip. The drop is now hanging from the cover slip. So you have the depression down here. So the depression is here. The cover slip is on the top. Okay, so the depression is down, cover slip on the top, and from the cover slip there is going to be the drop which will be hanging. Are you able to see it? See the drop. It's a very small drop. Don't keep a huge drop because it will touch the tip of the depression slide. It should not touch the cavity of the slide. It should be just hanging. It should be hanging. So place a small drop of the suspension and then prepare the slide. So now what we are supposed to do, the next step is, once the slide is ready, we are going to focus it under the low objective, 10x. So once you keep it under 10x, the microscope, you are supposed to locate for the edge of the droplet. So you have to move to the front or to the back and position the curve, that is the edge of the droplet. So once you locate the edge of the droplet, now you change the objective to high objective, 45x. Now after changing it to 45x, with the fine adjustment, you try to check the motility of the organism. So nicely you will be able to see the organism. If they are motile, you can see them the swimming motility. As we have taken Pseudomonas, in the theory also it has been told that it is an example for a monotrichous bacteria. So it's going to have the flagella at one end, and with that flagella it is able to perform the swimming motility. So now I'm going to focus it at the 10x. We will take some photos for you, snaps, where you can see the edge of the droplet first. Then we will try to capture the video where we can find the motility of the organism.